week, and 5 we might be weak, and 6 they kick out the door, the door.
And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. Diamond Dynasty Baseball coming your way on the show. It's the New York Mets and the Reapers. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. All right, ready to get underway. Here's Brandon Nimmo.
The center fielder, number 9, Brandon Nimmo.
And a pitch.
First pitch, 1 o'clock.
Foul ball, it stays nothing and 2. Got him swinging. Starling Marte up to hit. And there's a foul ball. And now the 0-1. Fought off foul. Here comes a pitch. Swing and a miss. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Pete Alonso. And first offering is fouled off. Kicks and deals. There's a strike. Got him! And how about that? It's an immaculate inning. Back now in the Bronx. Here's Gleyber Torres. The pitch. That misses, and that's ball one. That one back up the middle, and it gets through. Now the left fielder, Don Mattingly.
Don Mattingly.
First pitch just misses.
Ball one, no strike.
And that's outside. Next pitch is popped up. And puts the squeeze on that. And there's one down. Here comes Aaron Judge. He swings and fouls one off. Aaron Judge in 2016 got 95 plate appearances and hit just 179. He kept that number, 170. Gleyber goes. Pitch is high. Throw to second, and he's out. Swing and a miss. 1-2.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him.
Got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Back here in New York, and now it's Frankie Lindor. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. And the pitch. And there's a ball. And you played behind guys, and they loved having your speed out there defensively. One of the things that we talk about is how much pitchers enjoy having those elite defenders behind them. The wind and the pitch. And a strike.
Boog, and the one thing about that is speed never goes in a slump, and defense shouldn't either. Hitting-wise, you can struggle, you can lose your mechanics, but the thing that you can do consistently every single game is play great defense if you're talented in that way, and this is what this guy does.
Now, Francisco Alvarez. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And as well, lots of pop in that bat. So you combine the slug with really good defense. Next offering is in for a strike. Ball and a strike. There's a strike. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout. Jeff McNeil stands in. First pitch doesn't find the zone. And base hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
Batting seven. The third base.
And next for the Mets, Brett Beatty.
Beatty.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering. That one missed. McNeil, the runner at first with two gone. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
Two strikes.
Got it by him for the K. Back in the Bronx, stepping in the long ball threat, Lou Gehrig. And here it comes. And Gehrig hit cleanup for that famed murderer's row lineup as the Yankees were rolling off one World Series title after another. On a line, base hit.
Batting fifth. Not short.
And now Derek Jeter.
Jeter.
That one's in there, 0-1.
Gehrig hit behind Babe Ruth in those murderer's row days. They both have tons of power, but their home runs had much different trajectories.
Next offering is in for a strike.
While Ruth hit these high, towering fly balls out of the park, Gehrig just crushes line drives into the stands. I mean, he hit absolute bullets.
Swing and a miss struck him out. So up next, Babe Ruth. Fastball almost got him there. Two balls, no strikes, the count. And fouled off. Nothing, nothing here in the bottom of the second. Next pitch downstairs. And now 3-1. And now it's filled up.
Good pitch down around the knees. You want to be there all game. In a park like this, a pop-up sometimes will carry out.
Left-hand hitter waits. Runner on the go. To the right side. Into the outfield. Base hit. Into third now. So runners at the corners and one out. One away, runners at first and third. Now it's going to be Anthony Volpe. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. And a good eye there.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boog.
Ground ball, left side. Baden to second. What a double play that was. Inning over. Top half of the third inning. Now it's the DH, Ronnie Mauricio.
Ronnie Mauricio.
The wind of the pitch. That one's in there. It's 0-1. Mauricio, just 21 years old, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. And that one is lifted in the air. Ruth going after it. And it's caught for the out. Rafael Ortega stands in.
The left fielder, number 30, Rafael Ortega.
And that's in there for strike one. Swing and a ball popped up. Jeter makes the catch, and there's two down. And here is Brandon Nimmo.
Three-pitch strikeout last time up. Got to put up more of a fight in this one.
And a foul ball. Nimmo goes 6 feet, 3 inches, hitting leadoff in today's game. And he's one of the few players in Major League Baseball born in the state of Wyoming. Two down, nobody on. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Left-hand batter waits. And downstairs.
It's a good take.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. Back at Yankee Stadium. And now, Mickey Mantle.
The center fielder, Mickey
Peterson, back to work. And that's down and away.
Nasty backdoor slider. There's really nothing you can do with that if you swing at it. So it's a good take by him.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
Two strikes.
And that one just missed off the outside edge.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Next pitch misses, and the count's full. Now this is in the air down the line. Marte going after it. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One up, one down. Gary Sanchez at the plate.
Gary Sanchez.
Worm burner into the outfield for a knock. Here is Gleyber Torres. One for one. He led off the bottom of the first with a single. Hot shot to third. Over to McNeil. Double play. What a twin killing to end the inning. Start of the fourth. Here's Starling Marte.
The right fielder, number six. Starling.
The wind of the pitch. Into center. Mantle under it. Makes the catch for the out.
Almost a loud start to the inning on that first pitch. Man, he's going to want that one back, no doubt.
Alonso in the box with one away as he takes ball one. There's a strike. One down, base is empty. And a count 1-2. Good eye right there. Next pitch misses inside, and a full count now. Got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it. Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. His first at bat was a strikeout. That misses, ball one. Ripped on a line and makes the play, and that's out number three. Back here at the ballpark, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's a big power threat, Don Mattingly. And first offering is fouled off. Mm-hmm. Ball one there.
I got one ball, one strike.
That's off the mark. Two balls and a strike. Kicks and fires. There's a swing and a miss.
Spin rate's outstanding on that high fastball. Really tough to hit.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Here is Aaron Judge. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Ball one, no strikes. That one ripped left field. Ortega going back on this one. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
And that one is lifted in the air. Nimmo ranging after it. And puts the squeeze on that one. And that ends the inning. Back in the Bronx, here's the power-hitting catcher, Francisco Alvarez.
Francisco.
Singing four homers in 22 games at Old Yankee Stadium. What do you remember?
Well, I remember my rookie year hitting two in one game. And, you know, before that game in the clubhouse, there was a gentleman there who owned a suit company there in downtown Manhattan. And he said to me, "Hey, kid, you hit a home run in the game tonight. Come over to the store tomorrow and I'll give you a free suit."
Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. And now here's Jeff McNeil. Single to right at his first trip.
McNeil.
And takes low for ball one.
So I went into the game. I happened to hit two. When I walked into the store the next day and he looked at me, he said, "You're trying to put me out of business, aren't you?" And that was a great, great experience that I had as a rookie playing against the Yankees, playing in New York.
And the right-hander deals. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. So did Super Joe give you two suits?
Super Joe hooked me up with two suits.
Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. And next for the Mets, Brett Beatty. And he takes a strike.
All ones to count.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air, shallow left field. Mattingly makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. We head to the bottom of the fifth, and the batter will be the shortstop, Derek Jeter. Out towards right center, that's well struck. Bangs off the wall. Safely into second. He's got a double.
Wastes no time there. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy. Didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep. Took the barrel right to it and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
Ruth in now. Takes ball one off the plate. And he's already singled in this game. And it's 1-1.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit's probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
Ground ball right side, down the line, and it's foul. And time called at the plate. Maybe trying to slow things down here in a crucial spot. And now it's 1-2. That one 95 to finish him off. And stepping in is the speedy Anthony Volpe. 0-1 so far. Misses outside, and that is ball one. That one missing inside. Appears they're working around him with the base open, Singy.
Well, you know, these 2-0 counts, Boo, they're just not what they used to be, and we sound like old guys when I say that. But ultimately, this is a strategic game, and you expect to see this type of approach by the pitcher in this situation.
He's going.
The pitch. Runner takes off. Pitch misses. And safe. It's a stolen base. Jeter takes his lead at third with one away. Hard hit, base hit, and they strike first as they take a 1-0 lead.
Well done, drives in the run. You'll often hear the phrase short to it, long through it, and that's a great example of it right there. Got the barrel in the hitting zone early, squared it up with the well-timed swing, and came away with a beautiful line drive into center field.
And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. Runner takes off. That's in for a strike. Throw to second and great jump. That one misses. Now 1-2.
No, he's not afraid to fall into a 2-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike if he swings or not.
2-2. Outside. And there's ball four.
Oh, looking for a swing and miss right there, or for the ump to help him out and make a call with that last pitch, but neither happened. Close pitch, but a good take to earn that walk.
High in the air, out to right. Marte moves under it. Makes the grab. Both runners tagging. Both runners able to move up a base, so it'll be second and third with two gone.
Now back, second baseman, Labor Torres.
Torres in the box now, takes strike one.
Well, impressed that he went right after him on that first pitch. That's the key. Try to get ahead in the count, then you can play around a little bit more as the bat expands.
Check swing. Now a look down to first. No, he held up. And a 1-1.
2-1.
And another ball. Second and third. Two down. And now a full count.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
In there, sets him down on strikes. Couldn't pull the trigger on a fastball at the knees. Welcome back. Top of the sixth inning. And now the DH, Ronnie Mauricio. The right-hander back to work. He swings and misses at the first pitch. 0-1. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Volpe makes the catch. One down. Rafael Ortega up now for the Mets. Popped out to left his first time. Swing and a line drive curling foul down the right side. Ortega, 31 years old, usually in center field, but today starting in left. 0-2 as he waves at that one.
One thing I always felt if I played left field instead of center field was that the ball gets out there to you pretty quick, and the most important play is that ball down the left field line, getting to it, cutting it off, making a strong throw to keep that single instead of turning it into a double.
Nimmo at the plate for the third time as he comes up empty there. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. Here's the 0-2. And that's outside. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The 1-2. Off the outside edge, and now the count is 2-2. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Well, we go bottom six. Here's the left fielder, Don Mattingly. Peterson back to work. Off the mark there, and it's 1-0.
For you growing up in New York City, I mean, you're a big sports fan. Tell me about your experience with the Yankees growing up.
I really went to Shea Stadium more than I did to Yankee Stadium. I grew up a Phillies fan. There was one game, though, that I went to as a kid. I sat in the upper deck. It was the game that Bo Jackson hit three homers in his first three plate appearances and then hurt a shoulder diving for Deion Sanders inside the park home run. That's probably the most memorable game that I ever attended as a fan at Old Yankee Stadium.
Come on, play this now, baby.
Judge up for the third time here. Watches that one miss. The next pitch misses. Now 2-0.
He's controlling things out there on the mound, not messing around at all. He's been in attack mode since the very start.
2-1 on Judge. And misses inside. Judge rips that one. Ortega makes the grab, and there's two gone.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Gehrig, the next to hit, takes ball one. Lifted in the air right center field. Nimmo ranging after it. Brings it in for the third out. Back for more from the Bronx. Now the number two hitter, Starling Marte. The pitch. There's the strike. In there for a strike at the bottom of the zone.
No balls, two strikes.
Swing and a ball popped up. Marte retired. And there's one down. And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Ground ball up the middle. Torres fires over to first. And that takes care of Alonso.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Lindor stands in now and watches strike one. And now the count is even. Two outs. Hard hit left side. In time to Gehrig, and that is that. Phil Bickford takes over on the mound.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their guys a chance to fight back into the game.
So digging in, Derek Jeter, 1-for-2. And a pitch. That's in there. Strike one.
Some guys are just more confident if they can track that first pitch out of the hand of the pitcher. They don't care if they fall behind 0-1.
Now fly ball to right center. Nimmo ranging after it. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away. So up next, Babe Ruth. And that one Wrapped foul. Pitch misses there. One and one.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high.
And that one lifted in the air center field. Nimmo puts it away for the out. And there's two down. Two outs, base is empty. Here's the third baseman, Anthony Volpe.
He was the big part of the field last time. Nice liner to center.
Swings through that one. 0-1.
Now there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
Next pitch is inside, and the count is 1-1. That's a little bit low.
Two balls, one strike.
And there's a ball.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
And it's ball four. He missed down low.
Well, that's a really good take right there, and that's just mentally prepared, knowing that if it's not on a tee, you're going to take that pitch because you still have one more strike to work with. Not easy to lay off, but he did an excellent job in that plate appearance. Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
The 1-0. They try another pitch out. Now 3-0. That one to first. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Back now in the Bronx. Here's the catcher, Francisco Alvarez. The pitch. And that's in for a strike. Comes up empty on the swing. 0-2 now. But why the kick, the pitch? Just misses there. And that one hit 97 on the gun. At the plate, Jeff McNeil, corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. And first offering is fouled off. On the ground to third. Throws across the diamond, and that quickly, two away.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
And time is called for a mound visit now. Big moment in this game, so they'll talk it over. Baden in the box here lets that one go for a ball. And now 2-0. That's in there. Late that time, and it's strike two. Bounce to the left side. Volpe throws it to first in time. And the Mets go 1-2-3. New arm out of the bullpen, Jeff Brigham.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
And now it's the catcher, Gary Sanchez.
The catcher, Gary Sanchez.
And he deals. And the pitch is outside, ball one. There's the strike. Called strike right there. They tried to get him to chase on a slider. Down and away. Struck him out looking.
Now back, second base.
Back to the top of the lineup. Here's Gleyber Torres. One for three. On the ground to third. To first, two up, two down.
Well, Boo, we talk about how the ball is coming out of the pitcher's hand. The way it comes out of his hand as an infielder, wow, really impressive.
Mattingly, the next to hit, takes outside. In the air, fairly deep to right field. And that is the third out of the inning. Clay Holmes taking over on the mound.
I think closer has to be one of the toughest jobs in baseball, and we see a pretty high turnover rate because of it. Every outing seems to be high pressure, this one included. We'll see if he can wrap up the win and get himself a save.
Ronnie Mauricio now. What are you looking to do in these spots? You're down a run. You're leading off the inning.
He's not a power hitter, a guy that's looking to tie it up with one swing. So he's going to take and get into this at bat and try to get deep into the bat, ultimately, however he can, get to first base.
Mantle pulls it down and he makes the catch. One away.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
That just misses. Ball one.
One ball, one strike.
Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Popped up. Torres pulls that one down, and there's two away. So the lineup flips over. Here's the Mets leadoff man, Brandon Nimmo. First pitch, and he just misses. One run game here in the top of the ninth. The tying run at the plate. Got him! And that's the ball game.
Well, this one was all about the pitching and defense. Outstanding job of the pitchers, really attacking hitters, trusting what the catcher was putting down, and trusting the guy standing behind him to make the plays defensively. Sometimes you want to see a high-scoring game, but sometimes you can appreciate the artistic beauty of what these guys did on the mound today.
1-0 the final. They hang on to win it by a run. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.